In an effort to be as transparent as we can be, I'll give you as much information as I can at this point. Louisville Metro Police Department's Public Integrity Unit will be handling this investigation, so I need to be very respectful of that and their investigation. So I will give you as much information as I possibly can. What I know as of right now is the Anchorage Police Department had an individual, a female individual, come to their station approximately 3:30 this morning with serious domestic, serious wounds from a domestic. Upon doing some research and investigation on the individual involved, they found out this individual also had felony bench warrants out of Boone County. An officer here from Anchorage came to this location with other various agencies surrounding the area here in Anchorage, Louisville Metro Police, and I believe Middletown was also here, to make contact with this individual and invest further in the domestic. At this point, they tried to make contact. He came to the door, but then barricaded himself inside. They tried to negotiate for several hours. That failed. At that point, they contacted our hostage negotiation team and our SWAT team to assist in getting the individual out. We also tried negotiating and de-escalating the situation. During negotiations, this individual approached officers in a threatening manner with a deadly weapon. Our officer discharged his firearm, striking the subject. Fortunately, with our SWAT team, we do have medics on scene. The subject was rendered first aid immediately and then transported to University Hospital.
Did he shoot? Did the suspect shoot, fire a shot?
At this point, I can't really go into a lot of details. I probably won't answer a lot of questions again, just out of respect for Louisville Metro's PIU.
But it was St. Matthew's SWAT team that came in?
Yes, it is a St. Matthew's officer who fired the shots.
Does this person live here at this address?
From what I gathered, yes, the individual does live here with the other party that was seriously injured.
The warrants out of Boone County, that's northern Kentucky?
Correct.
Can you say what they were for or how serious they were?
At this point, I just know they're felony charges, and I don't really know what they're, I don't know what those charges are. I just know they are felony charges.
And so it was a St. Matthews police officer who fired at the suspect?
Correct. It was only our St. Matthews officers inside, plus our SWAT team medics, who were inside when these shots were fired, and that's why we were able to render aid so quickly.
And did that suspect approach police with the weapon in hand?
That's the way it appears at this point. Again, I don't want to step on the investigation that Louisville Metro is doing, so we'll let that sort itself out. You know, I want this to be totally transparent. Let them investigate it as they see fit, and when they want to release more information, that will be up to them, you know, I guess, if we confer together and want to release that information. But I'm in favor of releasing as quickly as possible. But really, that's their investigation. I'm not going to disrespect, you know, their willingness to help us and get this situated out.
Is it a help when you're familiar with 8th Division officers and the homicide or officers as well from Metro Police? Is that all help that you guys, you know, you work well together, you've worked together before?
It always helps that we work well together. I mean, we're here to assist each other. Obviously, this was a dangerous situation. Anchorage only had one officer out. That's why Louisville Metro came to assist, and I believe Middletown came to assist. When that failed, obviously, they called us to assist in getting this individual out.
When were you notified that one of your officers was involved in the shooting?
Shortly after our arrival here, they had tried negotiations for an hour or two, and that's when we're told that a shot was fired, or shots were fired.
Can you walk us through the civilian population about why St. Matthew's police doesn't investigate this? What happens?
For obvious reasons, with, you know, departments becoming more transparent and the way things politically are taking place, we want to be totally transparent in what we do. So therefore, you know, it doesn't look good that you're investigating yourself. So we want an outside agency who has the experience to do that. St. Matthew's doesn't truly have a public integrity unit as such. That's what these guys are trained to do. So that's why we rely on them to investigate our officers to determine exactly what occurred. And, you know, what their investigation shows, it is what it is, and that's what we'll go with.
What are they doing right now?
At this point, we're obviously securing the scene. They'll take care of the scene there. They will investigate and interview the officers involved. And then it's just it's sadly a long drawn out process from there, because you got to give time for officers to decompress and actually get their thoughts together, because they're involved in a very traumatic situation.
But only one officer fired shots?
Only one officer fired shots, to my knowledge, at this point.
And it's shots or shots?
I believe shots, but I am not sure. Again, that's their investigation.
Has Anchorage said anything about responding to this home before? Is there a history?
That I don't know. Again, just coming on scene, I was more concerned about the officer and individual involved, so my focus has been on the shooting itself.
Is he taken to University Hospital?
Taken to University Hospital.
Barry, whenever he barricaded himself inside the building, was the victim in there with him, or was it just him by himself?
Just him by himself. So the victim is safe and secure from the point that she made it to the Anchorage Police Department.
Did she notify them that he had a weapon, or did they just see it when he came to her?
That I'm not sure of. That's, I don't know.
Do you know the relationship? Was it a boyfriend or a husband?
I believe his boyfriend. They've lived together for a while from what I gather. Again, I don't know how long or what the situation is, but I do know that it is considered a domestic violence definition of somebody living together or in that capacity.
Is he somebody who's well known?
You're asking me a question. I don't know. So, guys, that's it. That's all I know. I don't want to step on their investigation. They're doing us a favor by doing it. Again, I want the investigation to be solid. Because we need to know what happened. The public needs to know what happened. And again, hate using buzzwords, but we want to be transparent to let people know what actually occurred.